must stop the glorification of violence in our society. This includes the gruesome and grisly video games that are now commonplace.
Those comments by President Trump after this weekend's mass shootings are putting video games into the debate about real-life violence. Right now, as is the case in every mass shooting, a debate is underway about what's to blame and how to prevent the shootings from happening again. But as Jordan Lippincott reports, evidence shows video games are not the problem.
The same talking point is brought about in literally every shooting since Columbine, and nothing ever happens to video games. It's more of a diversion than anything.
Some gamers in Acadiana are certain video games do not trigger violent behavior.
No one picked up a violent video game and thought, oh, I can do this in real life. They knew what guns were beforehand. It has nothing to do with it.
A 2015 review by the American Psychological Association found insufficient evidence to link violent video games directly to real-life violence. But Brianna Spriggs, a licensed counselor with the Family Tree, says in certain cases, children can be more influenced by the games they play.
The two major factors that kind of make the difference is if the person already has violence in their family and the child's temperament.
Spriggs urges parents to determine what's best for their children.
You can't blame a work of art for inspiring a murder. That simply is just what one person woke up and decided to do that day.
In Lafayette, Jordan Lippincott, KATC TV3.